Hey everyone, I'm Terry G. Thanks a lot for stopping by and watching my video. If you could take a second, can you please subscribe to my channel? I'd really appreciate it. Again, thanks a lot for stopping by. I want to talk about a statement or a word you hear in early recovery. And you know, people with, you know, 3-4 months in recovery, I'm sitting there and I hear they say to me, you know, I want to be in a relationship. And I'm like, you want to be in a relationship? You say that to most people, they laugh. You want to be in a relationship with 2 months sobriety or 6 months sobriety? Or some people kind of scratch their heads and go, oh God, a relationship. And the reason we do this in recovery programs is because we know what it means, that most relationships are, you know, partners in sobriety. And I'm not talking partners dating people in recovery, just dating in general or being in a relationship in general when you're in early recovery. It's kind of laughable, but also it's very dangerous for both people and mainly for the person in recovery because it can cause relapse, cause major problems. What a lot of people are looking for in early recovery, and you can tell me I'm full of shit if you want, is basically three things. We're looking for romance. We're looking to get fulfilled, like our loneliness from us. We feel so lonely. We're looking for somebody to fill that void of loneliness. And the granddaddy of all, we're looking to get laid or having sex. That's basically what it is. Because if you're in early recovery and you think that you are capable of having a relationship, and maybe you're going to be the lucky one that you have a great success rate of having a partner in your life and everything working out, you know, the white picket fence, etc. You might be the lucky one, but I haven't seen too many of them. Most alcoholics are mentally disturbed just because of the nature of alcoholism. We are crazily codependent, we are emotionally needy, and we don't know how to behave in any sort of relationship because we can't have a relationship with ourselves. We can't even live with ourselves, and we're gonna drag somebody else into our lives, and automatically life is going to get better. Well, it'll seem to get better. You know, you're having lots of sex, it'll be fun. You'll have that, you know, that spark which starts off in those relationships, and that's very, very great to have. It's fun to have a relationship with somebody. But eventually, you have to start talking to them. You have to start helping them or being understanding to them, and we just don't have it to give. And that's the problem. We just don't have what it takes to give in a relationship, having a partner in our life. And it's no fault to ourselves. It's just that alcoholism, active alcoholism, has distorted our emotions, our way of thinking, our value systems, our morality. It's distorted everything. So when we bring somebody into our lives, a partner into our lives, we think we can handle it, but we can't. We can't. Some people can, but most of us can't. And I only say it from my own experience. I caused a lot of problems to people I dated in sobriety. And these people were in the program and some of them were not in the program. But I caused a lot of grief because I was very codependent. I was very angry. I was lying. I was afraid to tell them the truth. I had a lot of issues. I had some court issues. I had some debt issues going on. Plus, I was working on my sobriety and had a lot of things going on in early sobriety that weren't conducive to being in a relationship. But because I was so horny and I wanted sex and I wanted romance, I wanted the spark of being with somebody and the loneliness I wanted to be gone, I would have taken anybody in early times when I was in recovery. I would have went out with anybody pretty well, mostly anybody, but really that's the truth of it. That's the truth of it. A friend of mine came up to me after a number of years of stumbling around dating and being in relationships. He said, Terry, why don't you just be by yourself and work on yourself? And you know, he was absolutely right. And that's what I did. I stayed by myself till I didn't want to be in a relationship, till I felt whole, till I felt that I had my program under control, for lesser words. I went to counseling. I did a lot of work on myself in order to be in a relationship. But most of us are masquerading around the rooms of recovery or through our lives thinking that we're in one, but basically all we want it to be is have romance, sex, and get rid of the loneliness. And that's what we're looking for. And if you really want to be honest with yourself, just look around at your friends who are in, have partners in recovery. Just look around, you know, in early recovery, just look around the people who are dating or in some hardcore relationships. Let me tell you something, they're pretty well hardcore relationships because usually they're a disaster. And I don't want to be the grim weeper when it comes to getting involved with somebody, but you need to give yourself some time to help yourself and to grow in your program, for you can learn about yourself, for you can have a relationship with yourself, because that's the most important one to have, is how to handle yourself during situations. Can I be understanding when there's no understanding? Can I love somebody when I really don't want to love them? Can I be responsible? Are my emotions dictating what I say? Are my emotions dictating my behavior? There's so much growth that needs to be done when we come out of an active alcoholism life, that one of the things that does not have to be done is to drag somebody into it and cause a lot of distortion in our program. It takes the focus off us. It puts it on them. It puts it on the relationship. We start to give up our program, not work as hard on it, because we're distracted from sex or from a woman or from a guy. We're distracted from it. Relationships distract us from our growth. There's a number of reasons why people say don't get involved with somebody in early recovery. It's a really big relapse, cause of relapse in recovery. I've seen so many disasters in people with early recovery being involved with somebody else. They go in with great intentions, but they come out beaten up emotionally, physically, financially. And for myself, I had charges against me, domestic abuse, all that kind of stuff. I don't even want to go back there. It was insanity run rampant. If you want to see somebody's maturity or somebody's place in recovery, just watch them go out with, be in a relationship. Just watch them. That's a big indicator. Most of us have disaster relationships because we're incapable. So if you can stay out of it, that would be my recommendation. If you don't want to, that's fine too. But be honest with yourself. Most of us are just looking to get laid and a little bit of romance and get rid of the loneliness. So be honest with yourself. If you can be honest with yourself, you can be honest with the other person and just tell them what's up. Be light, don't take it so serious. Just maybe date at the start and don't get emotionally involved with that other person. Because alcoholics, like I said before, are totally codependent. You know, the old saying is, all codependents are not alcoholics, but all alcoholics are codependent. And research the word codependent and maybe read a little bit on the internet what it all means, and you'll see how it goes. Because we can fool ourselves into thinking we're ready. We can fool ourselves, but we have to get honest with ourselves. You want good recovery? You want great recovery? Stay by yourself as long as you can when you first come in. Get your life in order. Get active in the programs. Build your life up. And you'll see the people that are attracted to you and you're attracted to them will be great quality of people, because that's the way it happened for me, folks. I had to do the hard stuff in the program. And one of the hardest things to do was to stay by myself and to work on myself, for I can be a better person for someone else and have a great partnership in a relationship. So that's my scoop on it. I hope I convinced you to stay out of relationships, especially in early recovery. And if you're having difficulties with your partner in early recovery, you might want to talk to a sponsor or a mentor and work it out. But do not drink, do not relapse over a bad result in dating other people, okay? So that's it, folks. The light's gonna go away here pretty soon. My name is Terry G. This is an alcohol-free life channel where we learn to live sober one day at a time. Thanks a lot for stopping by, and stay safe, stay sober, and hey, I'll see you next week. Bye-bye. Bye.